billions of people today. Let's take a look at the problem. Can you run the video, the previous one? Today, the world is witnessing an increase in water demand. Billions of people today are already water scarce. This number will increase up to 3 billion by year 2050. The household demand, agriculture demand and the industrial demand. It also, there is a lack of safe drinking water, and 2 billion people have already anyone can ask the questions, is there any way out of the disaster? Can we reverse the damage, or can we make up for our sins against the nature? And yes, we can, it is possible. And the answer is in nature. By applying or by adopting nature-based solutions, we can rectify or de-accelerate these problems. Nature-based solutions are certain measures which can sustainably manage the ecosystem and rehabilitate the problems and issues that we have already been witnessing. Nature-based solutions are the restoration of forests. Can you give me the mic? The restoration of forests, the floodplains, recreating buffer vegetation along the waterways, and management of soils can remedify and decelerate these problems. Nature-based solutions not only support the achievements of Sustainable Development Goal number 6, that is, safe water and sanitation for all, but at the same time, it plays an important role in the achievement of many other Sustainable Development Goals. For this purpose, we have to adopt a combination of green infrastructure as well as gray infrastructure. Green infrastructure are those which can affect and which are effective, resilient, and can create sustainable results. It's a combination of natural and semi-natural systems. whereas the grey infrastructures are the layered structures like a combination of steel and concrete. They are single purpose, and in case of water, like pipelines, storages, and treatment plants. Green infrastructure might be the wetlands, the tree houses, the tree boxes, and the rain garden. And infiltration plants, permeable pavements are also part of the green infrastructure. Whereas grey infrastructure are the culverts, pipes, and different drainage systems. Nature-based solutions might be the river flood, plain regulation, the restoration of natural wetlands, grasslands, and forests. Preparation buffers along the water lines, that is the land which can restore or reduce the adverse effects on the adjacent lands. They can reduce the effects of the land uses on the current waterways. Sand dams is yet another nature-based solution which retains sand rather than water. When sand accumulates behind the dams, this absorbs water from the seasonal floods, and this water can be used for the different purposes, as can be scooped up from the soil. Another important and very effective solution might be a good solution is the idea of spawn cities. It's a combination of nature-based as well as urban infrastructure, like green roofs, rain gardens, permeable pavements, and biosphere. The main idea behind this is to manage the urban water runoff and flood system, and it is being considered that it will achieve 70% of the, it will absorb 70% of the stock water. Permeable pavement, it might be used as a very important part of the spawn city, and this type of pavement is very effective in absorbing the surface runoff and recharging the groundwater daily at the same time. Biospheres again are the ditches which can be filled with vegetation and compost, and it can absorb water and again for the same purpose can recharge the groundwater. So all the water issues can be rectified and be celebrated by combination of green and grey infrastructures at the same time, which is very necessary. So the work of water, having said all that, the work of water has only dawned on us as the well started getting dry. Nature has solutions, but we need to change, not merely the rules, but the game itself. The challenges are there, but if you can dream it, you can do it.